Here's why you should test your capacitor. Hey guys, today I will show you how to test a capacitor with a multimeter. Step by step. To comprehensively test a capacitor, you will need next tools. Multimeter is the main testing tool. 9-volt battery. Jumper wires. Soldering iron and protective gear. You can get all these tools from the link in the description. Now let's go back to testing the capacitor. There are three capacitor tests: resistance testing, capacitance testing, and voltage testing. Let's start with the resistance testing. The first thing you need to do is remove the capacitor from the circuit. You can do this with the help of a soldering iron. The second step is to discharge the capacitor. There are several ways to do this. If you are discharging a capacitor for the first time, be sure to watch our video on this topic by clicking on this text above. That video will help you safely discharge the capacitor without injury. The third step is to set the multimeter to measure resistance. The 2 mega ohms range is the most preferred option, as you may get an infinity reading immediately after you run the final step of our test. Now place the probes of the multimeter on the capacitor. With a good capacitor, the multimeter first a value close to zero, then this value progressively rises till it gets up to infinity. The resistance test is good. Let's see the capacity test. For the capacitance test, you need to set a larger capacitance value than the capacitor. This capacitor has a value of 10 microfarads, so we put 20 microfarads on the multimeter. And be sure to discharge the capacitor before this test. Simply connect the capacitor to the multimeter. And as we can see, the capacitance test is good. And the last test is the voltage test. Here you should simply connect the plus end of the battery to the plus end of the capacitor, with the help of jumper cables. And then the negative end of the battery to the negative end of the capacitor. Set the multimeter to a higher reading than the battery. That means you should set it to a higher reading than 9 volts. Then place the red probe on the plus and the black probe on the minus. And we got 9 volts. That means this capacitor passed all three tests and is working properly. I hope you learned how to test a capacitor with multimeter. If this video helped you, please subscribe to the channel. It helps us to keep posting educational videos. See you.